Hi Sag, welcome back. So today we're doing a general message for your sign, which of course means that this may or it may not resonate with all of you, okay? And also the energy can be interchangeable, guys. It could be the other person or yourself. Just take it how it fits. So up here at the top, we've got your oracle messages. Over here on the left, we have your energy, Sag. Here in the center, we have your partner or whoever it is that you're connected to here. And then on the right, we have some near future potential outcome energy, okay? So where things might be headed here soon, as well as some advice messages down here at the bottom, okay? So let's get going. We're gonna start with your oracles first, and then we'll get into the actual message, okay? So coming out first here, we have separation, and it says time apart from your partner is on the horizon. Some of you, you've already been through this, okay? You and this person have been separated or broken up for a while here, okay? Others of you, if you're still talking to them currently and things seem a little bit rocky, or you guys just aren't really on the same page, I don't see a breakup necessarily happening. Maybe, again, you guys just need some space or time apart, and someone could be withdrawing their energy from this. Now, next, we also have release your ex, and it says the time has come for you to clear your energy. So, yeah, some of you, this could be about an ex or someone that you have some history with. I feel like this has not been a connection that's been easy to let go of, okay? There is still some residual energy here, even though you guys have been in separation for a while, okay? Now, next, we also have this could be the one, and it says you've already met the romantic partner that you seek, all right? So again, this is someone that you already know, okay? And again, some of you may still be talking to this person at this time. So let's get going. We're gonna start with your energy first. As you guys have the Seven of Pentacles here and the Knight of Cups. Whoever this is, I think that you do still care about this person, okay? You may be waiting on something as well with that Seven of Pentacles energy. It's about willing to invest and, again, waiting. So you might be wanting an answer here, some sort of clarity or closure or just communication, okay? You may want to hear from this person because you do still like them, okay? Or you still have some sort of feelings for them there with that Knight of Cups. Now, they have the Knight of Pentacles and the Seven of Wands. So I see where they do want to come towards you, okay? But they're taking their time. They're being very slow moving here, or it just seems like things are not going to another level fast enough, okay? This person may also be dealing with some financial issues. Maybe money isn't coming in fast enough for them, okay? And maybe they've kind of shut themselves off from you for that reason, okay? People do that. You know, people, when their money isn't right, they may tend to withdraw, okay? So that could be what's happening here for some of you and this person. Now, I'm also seeing here, because we have the Seven of Wands, this is about someone being very guarded and defensive, okay, having a wall up. Some of you, this person may be carrying that type of energy, but for others of you, I feel like they want to approach you, okay, with that Seven of Pentacles, but they're a little bit apprehensive, or maybe even a little bit scared that you're not going to accept them, okay, that you're not going to be open to what they have to say, all right? So, yeah, they could be fearing rejection there. Now, back over here to you, you have the Six of Wands and the Ace of Cups. So you do want a victory with this situation, okay? Some of you do want to renew this connection, and you want their attention here, okay, with that Six of Wands energy, all right? But you also want respect and appreciation and to be valued, too, with that Six of Wands, all right? Because the Ace of Cups here, too, also represents a lot of healing and self-love, okay? So some of you, you've done the inner work, okay? And again, you want someone who's going to appreciate you and value you and see you for who you really are, all right, guys? Now, next, they also have the Six of Wands, okay, and the Magician. So some of you, you guys are marrying each other with that Six of Wands energy. So yeah, they want your attention too. They still want to entertain this connection and manifest this situation. But the Magician can also be someone who's an illusionist, okay, a trickster, a manipulator, all right, someone who makes people believe things that are not real or true, okay? So somebody here could have been in some sort of an illusion, all right, guys? But next, you guys also have the Queen of Wands and the Strength card. Some of you could be dealing with a Leo, all right? But this is very positive energy here that some of you are carrying, okay? The Queen of Wands, she's someone who's very beautiful, attractive, confident, okay? Someone who many people want to date, whether you're a male or a female watching, okay? The cards aren't gender specific. And so, yeah, you're coming back into your power here, all right? You know you have what it takes, okay, Sag? Now, regardless of whatever this is about, it could be about this relationship, or it could be about something else. It could be about your goals or your work or whatever it is. But With the strength card being here, this is about confidence, willpower, okay? You pushing forward regardless of whatever kind of obstacles you've been dealing with, okay? So that's good. Now, next, they also have the Seven of Pentacles and the Lovers. Yeah, so both of you have the Seven of Pentacles, all right? So I think here this person may be waiting as well. Both of you may possibly be doing a tit-for-tat type of situation here, or both of you are just waiting to hear from the other, okay, if that makes sense. All right. Now, with the Lovers being next, you guys may be dealing with a Gemini here, but this is a very strong connection that this person still feels with you. Okay. One that they feel is still worth investing in, or they've been reminiscing about this situation that you guys had. Okay. Now, next, you guys also have the Eight of Swords and the Star card. Some of you might be dealing with an Aquarius. Okay. Now, some of you, you're a little bit anxious here, or you feel kind of stuck a little bit, either stuck on this person or there's some other kind of restriction in your life to where you feel like you can't get out of something. Okay, but I think that's just a temporary energy. All right, guys, because with the Star card here, this is all about healing and having faith and hope, either in yourself or this connection still. All right, so that's not that bad. Overall, I think your guys' energy is pretty good here, okay? Now, for your partner here, they have the Two of Cups and the Eight of Pentacles. So yeah, they feel like there is a bond here between the two of you, maybe a telepathic one, if I hadn't already said that, or a soulmate connection, excuse me, that you guys have, and they do want to put the work in, okay? But some of you are dealing with someone who is dealing with someone else, okay? Because I see two connections here with the Lovers and the Two of Cups. So yeah, they may have another option. Some of you are already aware of that, okay? So let's get over here to the right and talk about some near future, you know, potential outcome energy where things might be going here soon. Again, we have the Five of Swords and the Five of Pentacles, okay? So Five of Swords, that does represent manipulation or mind game, selfishness, someone, you know, who may just be all about themselves, okay, a taker. And, you know, with the Five of Pentacles is someone being left out in the cold, okay, rejected, abandoned, neglected, whatever the case is. There also could be financial problems that somebody is having here. Somebody may also be getting put out. All right. Now, next, we also have the Star card and the Ace. Sorry, not the Ace, the Knight of Swords there. So again, like I said, somebody still has faith in this connection, even if there is mind games and manipulation or people getting ghosted or stonewalled or whatever. Somebody still has faith in this connection and still wants to talk and communicate here, okay, with that Knight of Swords energy. Now, next, we also have the Two of Pentacles and the Magician. All right, so someone's struggling. I just mentioned that, okay, that this person may be dealing with someone else, or maybe you are Sag, or this could be someone juggling finances, okay, trying to make ends meet here, picking up a second job, or trying to create a second source of income here, all right, but, or this could be a decision that someone's trying to figure out whether or not this is, you know, even worth still manifesting or investing in here, okay, with the Magician. Now, next, we also have the Page of Swords and the Three of Wands. Somebody's at a distance, or there's travel involved here, or this person may live in a different city, state, country, whatever, all right? But somebody is spying, maybe on somebody online, okay? So if it's not you doing the Sag, it could be the other person. If they have access to see you online, or you guys are friends on, you know, the social media platforms, they may be looking for you or looking at you, all right? Wondering what you're up to, what you're doing here. And again, the Three of Wands can represent waiting as well, okay, waiting for communication here. So that was that. Let's go ahead and talk about your advice messages really quickly. These may pertain to this situation, okay, or it may be about something else in your life, okay? Just take it if it resonates with you. So first out here, we have peace, and it says, there is no need to worry as everything is working out beautifully. All right, guys. So some of you, yes, you've been worried here with this Eight of Swords about something. I don't know if it's this person, could be money, could be health, could be something else, okay? But yeah, Spirit is saying that you don't need to worry. You're going to be all right, okay? There is healing happening here. Now, next, we also have Medicine Woman, and it says, you are a channel for divine healing power. Maybe some of you work in the medical field, or this could be some of you were having health concerns, okay? I think you guys are going to be all right, though. Now, next, we also have Start Delegating, and it says, ask others, including me, to help you instead of trying to do everything by yourself. Okay, so that's what came out, Sag. Overall, I don't think this was really a bad reading. Okay, just to kind of reiterate everything here, some of you, you do still care about this person, like I said, okay, but you also are starting to realize your worth and your value, okay. And some of you, you're just not wanting to settle anymore. I think this was a situation that was hard to let go of, again, with the release your ex energy, but you guys have been healing. This person here, I think they do still care. They do, all right? But they got other stuff going on, or either they're just moving too slowly here, or they're dealing with someone else, okay? So that's what came out, Sag. And if this resonated, feel free to like, share, comment, and subscribe, okay? Thank you guys for tuning in. Wish you the best. Take care.